Welcome to New York Yankee Baseball. From Royal Stadium, the Yankees meet the Kansas City Royals. Participating advertisers are the Miller Brewing Company, brewers of light beer. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less. And Toyota, the official car of the New York Yankees, hopes you'll enjoy tonight's game. You asked for it, you got it. Toyota. And Manufacturers Hanover, where it's banking the way you want it to be. And Burger King, where you get the best darn burgers, all 100% pure beef. And Pepsi Cola and your local Pepsi bottler. Have a Pepsi day. Colonial Provision Company, the makers of Yankees Franks, with the taste that takes you out to the ballgame. Con Edison, serving 9 million people in New York and Westchester. The 70 greater New York area Midas dealers who say, when it comes to your car, don't compromise, Midasize. And the New York Yankees. Well, from Royal Stadium, it's time for New York Yankee Baseball. I'm Frank Musser along with the scooter Phil Rizzuto. And we'll be joined a little bit later by Bill White for tonight's game that winds up the current Yankee road trip. And of great interest right now to the fans here at Royal Stadium, a hang glider. And that is a live shot from one of our cameras hanging right over the ballpark. And he'll be drifting right over the fountains there in just a moment. First time I've seen a hang glider, Phil Rizzuto.
I said it's very exciting, Frank. For a moment there, I was scared. There was a helicopter coming in on the same wavelength. And he just did avoid him.
You're scared of the first robin of spring.
Yeah, I really am. Anything that flies or wiggles.
All right, Phil Rizzuto, tonight the Yankees have a chance to wind up a very successful road trip. They have won 5 out of the first 6 games. Chance to make it 6 out of 7 with Guidry tonight.
Well, Guidry is their ace, and they need this game very badly. They lost a heartbreaker last night to the Kansas City Royals, and with this win tonight, the Yankees will be returning home for their longest homestand of the year. And I think that's very important.
Very true, and I think if the Yankees are going to make a serious move, they'll have to make it within the next 2 or 3 weeks with that homestand. And, of course, tonight is the first night for manager Bob Lemon, who is in uniform and right now down at home plate. We'll be back with the starting lineups and the start of tonight's ball game in just a minute.
Manufacturers Hanover. All banks are not the same. At Manufacturers Hanover, it's banking the way you want it to be.
Now you can get more than your money's worth at your Toyota dealer's buck stretching days. We have thousands of new Toyota cars and trucks, and we're ready to deal. Prices start as low as this for the Corolla two-door sedan. Plenty to choose from. See why Toyota is America's number one selling import car. Immediate delivery. And you get a free digital watch when you buy any new Toyota. Hurry, offer ends August 31st. See your participating Toyota dealer and get more than your money's worth.
Which hitters will lead the Yankees in batting average, home runs, and RBIs this season? If you think you know, why not enter the Miller High Life Yankee Hitter Sweepstakes? There will be more than 100 winners. And first prize includes a Panasonic video cassette recorder, a 19-inch color TV, and a pair of box seat tickets to all Yankee home games next season. Official rules and entry blanks are available at participating Miller High Life retailers. Or send a self-addressed stamped envelope to be received by August 15th to Miller High Life Yankee Sweepstakes, Post Office Box 8000, Blair, Nebraska, 68009.
Thank you.
This copyright program is authorized under rights granted by the New York Yankees solely for the entertainment of our audience, and any publication, reproduction, or other use of the descriptions and accounts of this game without the express consent of the New York Yankees is prohibited. At first base for the Royals, John Wathen. The second baseman, Frank White. And right alongside White, the shortstop, Fred Patek. And playing third base, George Brett. The left fielder is Clint Kirtle. The center fielder, Amos Otis. And back in the lineup tonight, after a prolonged absence with injury, Al Collins is in right field. Catching, Darryl Porter. And the left-hander, Paul Splitoff, on the mound, making his 23rd start of the year. He has relieved once this season. 11 wins, 8 losses. He has pitched 157 innings to an earned run average of 3.22. Big guy, he doesn't overpower you, puts the ball in play. He has walked 29 and struck out only 38 men in his 157 innings. Against the Yankees' lifetime, he has won 11, and he has lost 6, despite a loss in his only decision with the Yankees this year.
New York.
Beautiful night for baseball here in Kansas City. Mickey Rivers will step in to lead things off for the Yankees, and in with the play-by-play, here is Phil Rizzuto.
All right, Frank Messer. Mickey batting at 257. 11 doubles, 5 triples, 5 homers, and 26 RBI. And a good breaking pitch over, strike called. Pitchers know that most leadoff batters like that fastball on the first pitch. And strike two. So he's outguessed Mickey on the first two pitches. But as they say in baseball, only takes one to hit it. Foul back, and it almost got Willie Randolph in the on-deck circle. That's a dangerous spot in a lot of ballparks. There's Willie, along with the bat boy. It was in the on-deck circle that Steve Yeager was kneeling when he got hit with the splintered end of a bat right into his throat and almost died. One ball, two strikes. It was a very warm day here today. Hot, I should say, in Kansas City. Beautiful evening. And a bouncer, and they're going to have trouble throwing Rivers out. They're not going to get him. And Mickey's going to go for two, and he'll make it easily. He might go for three. Nope. They had no chance to get Rivers, and that'll be a double off the glove of Patek.
Watch it again. Pitches down low. Mickey bounces it. Off the artificial surface, Splitoff can't get it. Patek coming on, deflects the ball away from Frank White. Had Patek not touched it, I think White would have held him to a single, but no chance of throwing Rivers out at first. As it is, he winds up at second.
All right. Oh, Mickey only needed that one strike to get a base hit. Here's Willie Randolph. Willie batting 250. 9 doubles, a triple, 3 homers, and 20 RBI.
Since he came off the disabled list, Scooter Randolph has played 9 games, and he's hit in 8 of those 9.
All right, his job now to either score Rivers or move him to third. Let's see how Willie approaches it, and he does check swing it in the short right. And it's going to be tough. Collins with a great arm. Rivers bluffs going and then comes back. That's got one of the strongest throwing arms and very accurate, Al Collins. Randolph was actually trying to check his swing on that one. There's Collins out in right field. There it was, kind of a half swing, just checked it. Collins makes the catch, set to throw, and Rivers wisely decided to hold, even with his great speed.
Number 15, Thurman Munson.
So one away, and the Yankee captain, Thurman Munson, batting 293 with 16 doubles, a triple, 5 homers, 44 runs batted in. Thurman has walked only 14 times all year.
Thurman had a 9-game hitting streak broken last night. In 9 of 10 games, he is 17 for 45.
All right, one man out in the top of the first. And a swing and a miss, strike one. Good slider right in on the hands of Munson.
Splitoff tonight is looking for his 101st Major League win. He got his 100th win in his last start, winningest pitcher in Royals history.
He's big, 6'3", 210 pounds. That's low and inside, 1-1. See what that Andy Hassler picked up a win in his first start for the Red Sox. Not first start, but his first appearance for the Red Sox.
That's right. It was his first appearance. Just traded yesterday from Kansas City to Boston. Day before yesterday, actually.
Slow curve down low. Two balls and a strike.
Hey, new record in the National League. Pete Rose just got a hit. We'll tell you more.
All right, 38 in a row, and as a foul, set strike two. Two balls, two strikes. Split off. Where's those large glasses? Looks like a school teacher out there. One man out, no score in the top of the first. Change up, bounce foul. Munson straight away. Outfield and infield. Mickey Rivers leading off second. He got him. A fastball right down the middle. Thurman swung right through it. First strikeout for split off. Here it is.
Batting fourth.
Man, that usually Munson's pitch. Two men out, and now Sweet Lou Piniella. Lou at 303. 11 doubles. All right. Two men out. Now Rivers still at second base. In the hole, but over there, Brett one-hands it. Off-balance throw, they got him. So the Yankees waste the double. No runs, a hit, no errors. One man left at the end of one half inning. The Yankees nothing, and the Royals coming to bat. Welcome, everybody, to the light beer battle of the big guys. And there they are, two teams locked in mortal combat to decide the eternal argument over light beer from Miller. On one side, the big guys who think the best thing about light is it tastes great.
Yeah, it tastes great.
On the other side, the big guys who think the best thing about light is it has a third less calories than their regular beer. It's less filling.
I feel strongly both ways.
I tell you, this is really no respect. Blue is the violet and red is the rose.
You don't fool them or break your nose.
The tension here is almost unbearable.
Oh, you guys.
They can't go on much longer. Something big has got to happen soon. Holy cow, look at that.
Hi, Mickey.
Hi, dolls.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
I still don't know why they asked me to do this commercial.
Funny, but I found the best way to cut down on cigarettes was good smoke.
Take a tip from the people who smoke Tipperillo.
It's the kind of taste that Lotars just couldn't give me.
I went from two and a half packs of regular cigarettes a day to two, maybe three packs of Tipperillos a week. Pretty good, huh?
My husband still enjoys smoking, but now he doesn't smoke as many cigarettes.
Tipperillo. It's a good tip.
All right, we'll check the Yankee defense for you in just a moment as Jim Spencer is at first base tonight. The second baseman, Willie Randolph. Brett Stanley, the shortstop. And Greg Nettles at third base. Lou Piniella is in left field. Mickey Rivers in center field. And Thurman Munson is the right fielder. Mike Heath does the catching. And with a record of 14 wins and only one loss, Ron Guidry on the mound. Guidry leads the major leagues in earned run average with a 2.11. Scooter?
All right, George Brett with a nine-game hitting streak takes the ball outside. He's up to 315. He's got that stroke back. They missed him when he was injured. And a good slider by Guidry, 1-1.
First base umpire tonight is Larry Barnett. Jimmy Evans is on the left side as we work with three umpires. And Marty Springs.
And there's a base hit for Brett. Dirty, he's got that stroke. It's exactly where the ball is pitched. Why, he's very seldom fooled. So he's hit in 9 consecutive games. Make that 10 now.
Number 11.
And that'll bring up Hal McRae.
As McRae steps in, we'll tell you more about Pete Rose. He singled a left in the top half of the third inning at Shea Stadium to break Tommy Holmes' National League record. Rose has now hit in 38 consecutive games. He singled up Craig Swan for the new record.
All right, McRae the batter. Swing and a miss. Strike one. McRae batting 268. That's well below his average. 24 doubles, 5 triples, 10 homers, and 45 RBIs. Right foot almost out of the batter's box completely. 1-1.
I don't know what Craig Swan's reaction was. I know last night when Pat Zachary gave up the record tying base hit to Pete Rose, Zachary wound up on crutches. He kicked something.
He kicked the batting helmet. Was that unbelievable? He was very upset with Rose getting the hit off him and losing the game, and he kicked a batting helmet.
Sure, it was a batting helmet, not a World War I steel helmet.
Said he must be a pretty bad soccer player.
Or strong batting helmet.
Runners going, and a foul back on the screen as they had the hit and run on. That's why Kansas City, Frank, is such a tough club to beat. They can beat you with speed, they can beat you with defense, with pitching, and with a lot of extra base hits, not necessarily the long ball.
Well, they'll get the extra base hits, especially here in this ballpark with the tartan turf. The ball really takes off. Hit anything in the gap or down the line, you got a double at least.
Foul back off the screen. Still a ball and 2 strikes. Well, there's no doubt that Kansas City has the edge playing 81 games on this artificial turf. Yankees come in. They just play either 6 or 7 games all year, and it's tough to adjust. Is a base hit to center field. Great try by Randolph, who took a hard tumble, went completely over and hit hard on the ground. Back-to-back singles. Time is called. And Willie Randolph shaking up on that ball.
Third.
There's Willie. He made a great try for that ball. Brett had to hold up.
There it is again. Ball is not hit that hard. Watch Randolph now. Right there. Thinks he has a chance and just missed it. And when he came down, you don't see him tumble to the ground, but he took a hard fall, but apparently is all right. One thing about it, he came down on his feet first, then went down. That absorbed some of the shock rather than hit on that injured knee flush on the hard surface.
All right, John Watson, the batter. Nobody out. And there's a strike call. So Guidry and the Yankees in trouble here in the bottom of the first. No score, but the Royals threatening. Watson got a big pinch hit in last night's ball game. He's batting 295. Foul out of play. Back in the second tier here at Royals Stadium.
Watson will platoon at first base with Pete LeCocq. LeCocq is a left-hand batter, and he'll start against right-hand pitching with Watson going against southpaws. And Clint Hurdle has found a home in the outfield.
All right, so Guidry ahead on the count, 0-2. Struck him out. Big strikeout for Guidry right there. He needed that one. Oh, let's see how many Mr. Guidry has.
Frank. That's his 146th strikeout of the year.
I believe Nolan Ryan crept ahead of him with his 11 strikeouts the other night.
Right, Nolan Ryan has struck out 153 men, so right now Guidry is 7 behind him with that strikeout there.
All right, Guidry now will have to face Amos Otis. Otis batting 278. He has 17 doubles, 3 triples, 14 homers, and 54 runs batted in. One man out, that's Brett leading off second. High ball one. Gray at first, Otis at second. Rather, Brett at second and Otis batting. Got it by him, 1-1. Good shot at Guidry. Those skinny legs, a wiry upper part of the legs. Where he generates that power from. Otis had asked for time and gotten it from the plate umpire. High fly, right field. Munson is back. Brett is tagging. McRae comes back to tag, but he'll stay there. Munson's throw cut off by Randolph. Brett goes to third. There are two away.
Batting fifth, number 15, Darryl Porter. Catcher.
Darryl Porter. Made a big difference in this Kansas City team. He's batting 280. Has 20 doubles, 3 triples, 8 homers, 44 runs batted in. Hitting Yankee, pitching very, very well. Little rougher tonight, though. Now he'll use that open stance as he does against left-hand pitchers. First and third, two out. Nice play by Mike Heath. He bluffs the throw to first.
Porter's had 12 hits against Yankee pitching, including 4 home runs and 8 runs batted in. He has scored 11 runs against the Yankees this year.
Check swing bouncer, and Guidry has it. Underhand toss. The Royals are retired. No runs, 2 hits, no errors, 2 men left. At the end of 1, the Yankees nothing and the Royals nothing.
You're next. Can I help you?
I don't think so.
Try me.
Well, how can I get a checking account that won't cost me anything?
At Manufacturers Hanover, just keep $400 in a savings or checking account, and your checking is free.
Oh, but I'm going to write a lot of checks. You see, I got Flannel of the Month Club, I got Cheese of the Month Club, I got Shirley's Psychiatrist. She's my canary. She's afraid of height.
Oh.
You got your own problem. Hi, how are you?
Hi.
Fine, thank you. What I'm trying to say is, well, what would they do to me if I accidentally bounced the check?
You can apply for overdraft protection, so if you write a check bigger than your balance, you're covered.
Gee, you thought of everything.
Sure.
How do I get here to cash my checks?
Well, how'd you get here today?
Well, I got lost. I work in Mineola.
We have a branch in Mineola, but you could cash your checks at any of our 200 branches.
Well, I'd rather do it here. I feel kind of at home.
Oh, that's very nice.
But where do I sign?
I'll get you a form.
Good. Oh, could you give me directions on how to get home?
To Mineola.
No, I live in Flushing.
Manufacturers Hanover. It's banking the way you want it to be.
This clock is not an ordinary clock. It belongs to the great time machine by Quasar. New VHS 4-hour videotape recorder. It's as easy to use as your own TV set. Quasar VHS lets you record, edit, and enjoy your own TV specials. Or enjoy those special programs available only on video cassettes. The Great Time Machine by Quasar.
Quasar makes television special again.
Well, the fans here politely applauded a moment ago when it was flashed on the message board that Pete Rose had broken Tommy Holmes' National League consecutive game hitting streak record with a hit in his 38th.
Number 9, Greg Neville.
A quick word about Yankee first baseman Chris Chambliss. He is not playing tonight because of a jammed left ankle. Chambliss, a jammed left ankle, keeping him out of the ball game tonight. Greg Nettles will lead off the second in a scoreless ball game, and here's Phil.
All right, Frank Nettles hitting 259 and pops this one sky high. George Brett moving under it and backing up, one hands it, one away. Towering pop foul. Brett stayed with it.
Batting six, number six.
That'll bring up Roy White.
White.
Roy batting 257 overall, right-handed. He's batting 315 for the Yankees. He has 6 doubles, a triple, 7 homers, and 25 runs batted in. Low score here. Yankees and the Royals, final game, final appearance for the Yankees here. Unless they meet the Royals in the playoffs. One ball on Roy White. Low, 2-0. All split off on the mound for Kansas City. lined, and Potsek leaps and grabs it. He timed that leap beautifully. Went down on his knees, waited.
Watch it again. Looks like a sure base hit off the bat, but Potsek way up in the air. Little man, 5'4", grew about a foot and a half right there as he speared that one.
All right, Jim Spencer, the batter. Spencer batting .218. Eight doubles, a triple, seven homers, 20 runs batted in. Frank told you, Chambliss out. Little problem with his left ankle. Low ball one. Bob Lemon, the new Yankee manager, who took over for Billy Martin, brought the lineup cards out tonight. Bouncer foul. One and one. Gene Michael up with it. There's Bob Lemon.
Right.
Excuse me, Frank sitting right at the end, and of course Billy Martin's familiar spot. Well, baseball, it's a great business when you're winning, making all that money, and it's tough when you lose, but it's got to go on, no matter who gets fired or who gets hired. Change up, curve low, 2-1. Bouncer to Watson. He'll make the play unassisted. Beat Spencer to the bag. The Yankees get down in order. At the end of an inning and a half, the Yankees nothing and the Royals nothing.
Who's got that same Royal Burger that is never fried? Burger King and I.
Some places fry their burgers, that's something we don't do. We broil our burgers on a flame, yeah, broil them just for you.
We broil them just for you.
At Burger King, we flame broil our burgers, never fry.
Who's got that same Royal Burger that is never fried?
Most optical stores look about the same. Frames, lenses, accessories. But at Sterling, there's more to eyeglasses than meets the eye. Our eye examination, for example. It's special because our optometrists are specialists. A recent survey showed that our average optometrist has been examining eyes over 23 years. He could probably test yours with his closed. Treat your eyes like they're special. Put them in the hands of a specialist at Sterling Optical.
Noisy muffler? Don't compromise.
Hey, your muffler, Midas sized it.
At Midas, the muffler specialists.
Tomorrow night, the Yankees will be back at Yankee Stadium to play the Cleveland Indians in the first of three games. Then Thursday, the Yankees and Indians clash in a rare weekday afternoon doubleheader, which will also be Senior Citizens Day. That'll start at 1 o'clock. Tickets for all three games are now on sale at Yankee Stadium, Ticketron, and all ticket outlets where you normally get Yankee tickets. I'll give you the pitchers for the Yankee-Cleveland series in just a moment, Phil.
All right, Al Collins batting .249. Checks his swing at slow ball one. Collins has been out for quite a while. Took him a little while to get back in the groove. Had a great year last year. Has 11 doubles, 7 triples, only 2 homers and 30 runs batted in. And a base hit. Said it. On natural grass and dirt, that ball would have been caught. But as soon as it's hit a little to the left or right of an infielder, you can see it picks up speed and they just cannot get to it. Collins hit a pretty good pitch that time up the middle for a single. Third hit, there it is.
Fred Stanley going to his left, just can't quite reach the ball. Now Al Collins in his first at bat after a lengthy injury comes back with a base hit.
Clint Hurdle hitting .264. Knocked down by Heath, picks it up, throw to second. Hey, they got him. Holy cow, what a play by Heath. I tell you, that kid blocked the ball, then jumped on it like a cat. Watch this play.
That is Heath scrambling out. Up with it. Good strong throw to Fred Stanley, and Collins is out easily at second base.
Oh, I tell you, that was some kind of a defensive play for the youngster. Ball two, and that's what wins you ball games, your defense. Clint Hurdle Last year's American League Player of the Week, rather last week, bounced his fence. He's going to have to flip to Guidry. He does, and they got him. And you saw how quickly Guidry got rid of that foot off the bag. A lot of pitchers have gotten spiked keeping that foot on the bag.
You look at Ron Guidry. Watch him. He'll be able to cover first base. He has the good instinct. Just looks down. Look at that foot come off of there in a hurry.
Sure, they nick you in that Achilles tendon. Forget it. Freddie Pacek takes the ball a little bit high.
Yesterday, Guidry dreamed of playing for the Yankees, but not as a pitcher. He dreamed of playing the outfield for the Yankees.
As a strike, 1-1. I heard him talking about that. He keeps wanting to take batting practice, but they all said they saw his act in last year's World Series. They don't want to see him hitting. There's a swing and a miss, strike two. Two out, nobody on, bottom of the second, no score. Patek hitting .277, 16 doubles, one homer, 37 runs batted in. Foul tip held by Heath, so Heath had a great defensive inning there. No runs, a base hit, no errors, nobody left. At the end of two, the Yankees nothing and the Royals nothing.
Hello, I'm Lisa Pulling, the director of the Fresh Air Fund. Again this summer, the fund is sending 15,000 of New York's neediest children to the country for free vacations. We have the host families, the camp is ready, and there are lots of children who could go if we had the funds. You can sponsor a child's two-week vacation in the country by sending only $42 to us. Your support will give a disadvantaged child an unforgettable experience. It's the best travel bargain around.
Before the summer sun spoils your fun, take advantage of ShopRite's great values on Dalgard summer coolant and antifreeze. Dalgard protects your engine from overheating and gives you the protection you need for hot summer driving. There's a special offer. Send two proof of purchase seals to Dow, and they'll send you a check for a free gallon. It's year-round protection for your car from your friends at ShopRite. Look for Dow Guard for only $2.79 per gallon, and stock up today.
Light beer from Miller tastes just great, and that's no fish story. But the best thing is, it's less filling. Light's got a third less calories than their regular beer. And that's important when you're trying to land that big one. Like yesterday, I hooked this bass, fought him for over 6 hours. All of a sudden, he jumps clean over the boat. Broke my rod, and I had to tie the... Now, wait a minute, fellas. I had to tie the line off...
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
Left me out there with nothing but a paddle.
Well, as Mike Heath steps in, we'll take a look at the scoreboard. Actually, we'll do it while the pitchers come, Scooter.
All right. Heath had his hitting streak stopped at 13 last night, takes a strike. Mike batting .283 with two doubles and seven runs batted in. No score, top of the third. Ball split off on the mound for the Royals. Inside, 1-1.
Baltimore jumped out to a 2-0 lead over Texas at the end of one as Ken Singleton hit his 11th home run of the year with a man on.
A little loop at a first base. Waffen will grab it. Foul ball, says the first base umpire.
Cleveland leads California 3-0 at the end of three. Toronto 2 and Seattle 1 at the end of six. Detroit 2, Oakland nothing at the end of three. And Milwaukee, Chicago scoreless at the end of one. Boston at Minnesota, it'll be Bill Lee against Roger Erickson. No report.
All right, Fred Stanley hitting .230. Takes the pitch down, low ball one. Chicken has five doubles, one homer, seven runs batted in. Bouncer to third, Brett has a nice hop. Takes his time and fires him out. So quickly, two men out here in the top of the third. Stanley heads for the bench.
National League, Bill, at the end of three, the Reds and the Mets are scoreless. Human Swan and Rose did get a base hit his second time up. Atlanta 4, Philadelphia nothing at the end of six. Montreal, Houston scoreless at the end of 1.5, and the other games are out on the West Coast.
All right, Mickey Rivers, who doubled off Freddie Pacek's glove his first time up. And he bounces one right to Pacek. Gets rid of it quickly. Now couldn't be handled by the first baseman. That could be an error charge to Pacek. And that's the benefit of River's speed.
That's right. He tried to hurry the play, and here's what happens. Potak charges the ball, comes up with it, came up with a nice hop, but he throws it in the dirt. See, it come up on that hop off the heel of the glove of Wappen. And Potak is going to be charged with an error.
So, River's speed makes the infielders hurry their throw. They can't quit and get set, and Potak has a great arm. He could have taken an extra second. Willie Randolph, fly to right first time up, takes a strike. Low, 1-1.
Just looking down the list, that was the 22nd error this year for Potak. Brett over at third has made 12. White at second has made 13. The reason I bring that up, I think the Royals really miss John Mayberry's glove at first base.
Oh,
Mayberry
yeah.
could handle those errant throws from the infield as well as anybody in the league.
There goes Rivers. Got a good jump. They'll never get him. Holy cow, not even close. Mickey Rivers got a tremendous jump that time.
There he goes. You see the jump he got off split off. He should never get that big a jump off a left-hand pitcher.
Nope.
And no play even at second base. He could have gone in standing up.
13th steal of the year for Mick. He's only been caught four times. One ball, two strikes on Willie Randolph. Yankees got a chance to get on the scoreboard here. And they do as Randolph drills one down the right field line. He'll get two on that one. Rivers scores easily, and the Yankees go on top 1-0. Willie went beautifully with that breaking pitch away. Just stepped towards right field and punched it out there.
Here it is again. Watch where the pitch is. Get away from him, and he stepped back and just drilled it hard down toward the right field corner. Ball kicks off the wall, and a good pickup by Cowens as Rivers crosses the plate. Two base hit for Randolph, his 10th double and 21st RBI.
All right, a big unearned run for the Yankees. The unearned against Paul Splitoff's earned run average, but it counts in the game. And here's Thurman Munson, who struck out his first time up. Hopped it up. And the second baseman, Frank White, chases Wathen off and makes the catch. But the Yankees pick up a run on a hit, one error, one man left at the end of 2.5. Yankees 1 and the Royals nothing.
Oh, doesn't anybody give you your money's worth these days?
You asked for it. Your money's worth and more. The Toyota Corolla two-door sedan, Toyota's lowest priced car. If you can find a better built small car than Toyota, buy it. We bet you can't, because Toyotas are built with the economy and reliability you're asking for. Now's the time to see how much satisfaction you can get for your money.
Finally, I'm getting my money's worth.
More.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
What time you go to sleep is your business. What time you wake up is Panasonic's. Panasonic introduces its electronic clock radios. A gentle chirp, silent, easy-to-read numbers, a doze button, and, of course, beautiful AM and FM. What time you wake up is...
my business.
Ours, too. Panasonic electronic clock radios and digital clock radios.
We both love all the Colonial Bacons. The only question is, Jim, which one is the best?
Let's see, Billy.
The special cut bacon? Cut from where the bacon's best.
Mm.
Colonial's maple sugar cured bacon with a Vermont country flavor. The lean taste of Colonial beef strips, a tasty beef blend.
You know, that's good, too.
Or Colonial smoky strips, a delicious combination of pork and bacon. Well, Jim, what's your favorite?
So far, the first four.
Next time you cook, and I'll choose.
Colonial Bacons. Mm. Which one is best?
Frank White will lead it off for the Royals here in the bottom of the third. Yankees lead 1-0. Ron Guidry, swing and a miss, strike one. White batting 280. He's having a fine year with the bat. 17 doubles, 3 triples, 3 homers, 30 runs batted in. This kid has really made himself a good ball player. What a difference, night and day from the time he came up. High fly to center, Rivers. Moving slightly to his left, and there's one away. That's the shadows of the fountain. You know, that'd make a great title for a song, The Shadows of the Fountain. Okay, I will. George Brett will single to center his first time up, the batter. Don Connie just told me I'd be a terrible songwriter. Can't even come up with a good song title. Strike one. All right, one strike on Brett. One out, Yankees lead 1-0. Foul tip, in and out of the glove, strike two. We have a couple of the Boardman family here with us. Sid and his son. That'd be another good song title, Sid and his son. Outside, one ball, two strikes. They play Brett straight away. And off Guidry's glove, but he's going to beat it out. Randolph up throw. They won't get him. Guidry did a great job getting his glove down to slow it down. Here it is again. He's an outstanding fielding pitcher. But this hit just too hard. Almost takes the glove right off his hand. Watch. Right there. It did knock it off his hand. He did slow it down, but a little too much. And let's see if Guidry's all right. He might have got hit on the thumb of the right hand. It won't bother his pitching. But if it should have hit it real hard and maybe a break or a bad bruise, he could be in trouble. Look at it again, Frank Messer. Knocks the glove right off.
Yep. Looks like what it did, it got his thumb. Gene Monahan, of course, out there right away to check on Guidry. It appears that he's all right. As you said, it's not going to affect his throwing. And we could just hope it is only a bruise. Obviously, it did hurt, though.
All right, one man out. That'll bring up Hal McRae, who's single to center his first time up.
That base hit's going to make Brett a 400 hitter here in this ballpark. Imagine that, hitting 400 here at home.
Well, I can see the way Brett strokes that ball, and with the artificial surface, he's going to get a ton of base hits. Foul back, strike one. Yankees in front, 1-0 here in the bottom of the third. Yankees last night were leading 2-0 up till the seventh inning. When the roof fell in, Royals scoring 4 runs. High, 1-1. Brett has 16 stolen bases on the year. Guidry does not have that good move to first. We'll throw over there occasionally just to hold the runner close.
With those 16 stolen bases, he's only been caught 4 times.
The toss over. And still another, but they're not even close. As we told you, Guidry does not have that good move. The only thing missing to make him a complete pitcher. He can do everything else. He can field his position, get the strikeouts, has excellent control. Change up way out of the strike zone, 2-1. Looks like Guidry is not a bad hitting pitcher. At least he wasn't when the era when the pitchers were hitting. That's it. Guidry almost stepped right towards home plate that time and threw that ball. Very close to a balk. Brett's going. Fouled off Heath's ankle, I think. He went down on one knee as the ball glanced off him.
Let's watch that pickoff move of Guidry's again right here. Look at that kick. Almost.
Starts towards first and brings it back. Count is even on McRae with 1 out. Brett does not have too big a lead. High, and it's 3-2. Guidry put a little extra on that fastball, and it really jumped.
This isn't a bad ballpark to pitch high in. It's a pretty good distance out there to the alley. It's 385 feet, 410 to center. You have to pull the ball right down the line for it to be close.
All right, Guidry figures that Brett will be running on a 3-2 count to McRae. McRae has struck out 38 times. He's going strikeout, throw to second, double play. Oh, that heat can fire that baseball. Frank Mess is going to carry you along for the next three innings. At the end of three, the Yankees one and the Royals nothing.
The all-wide body airline to California, United.
United 747 cleared for takeoff.
Roger, United 747 cleared for takeoff.
Every day, every night, every flight, a wide body.
United DC-10 cleared for takeoff.
The all-wide body airline to California.
United 747 cleared for takeoff.
Roger, United 747 cleared for takeoff.
We built the largest airline in the free world around you.
Hi, I'm Lou Piniella. Whenever I have a minute, I like to find out what's happening in other sports, so I call Sports Phone. 999-1313. That's 999-1313. It's fast and it's first with news about all sports. Hey, they won! Gotta go now. If you can't get to the game, get to the phone. Sports Phone, 999-1313!
When we made our first White Owl Invincible, we knew cigar lovers would love it. But we had no idea how much. For years, it's been the biggest selling White Owl. And why not?
Look at that classic shape, huh? Mm. And when it comes to mild, this is why the word was invented. The White Owl Invincible. Mm. We're gonna get ya. Mm-hmm. Oh, we're gonna get ya. We're gonna get ya.
All right, we'll go to the fourth inning here at Royal Stadium. The Yankees one run, two hits. The Royals no runs, four hits. And that's the best-looking fountain I've seen all year. I'd like to have that in my front yard or my backyard or my patio. Getting closer. Lou Piniella will lead things off. Lou bounced out to the third baseman, George Brett, his first time up. On. It isn't often we ask a broadcaster for another team to sit in here with us, but we're going to make an exception tonight in just a moment. Two balls and no strikes, because we have with us a gentleman who is the color commentator for the Seattle Mariners on their telecast. He also dabbles around with some of their young pitchers, and he was also a 20-game winner for the New York Yankees. Of course, I'm talking about, and we'll be talking to, foul ball, Mel Stottlemyre. Mel, great to see you again, buddy.
Nice to see you again, Frank.
Hey, just quickly, as the new ball comes into play, catch us up. What you been doing over the last few years?
Well, I better clarify what I have been doing. I'm really not the color commentator. I'm just going to do a couple of games to get by. Rico Petrocelli has signed on for the color commentating job, but I'm minor league pitching coach for the Seattle Mariners.
Piniella pops it up down the third base side. Brett comes in about halfway to the mound. And we have one out here in the fourth. Well, Mel, you're keeping your interest in baseball. How do you like working with the youngsters?
Frank, I like it real well. Last year was my first year after being out of baseball for a couple of years, and I really enjoyed it. The Seattle club only had one minor league club, and it didn't take up too much of my time, but this year they have three clubs, and I've been quite busy, been doing a lot of traveling in California and the state of Washington.
Greg Nettles takes that slow curve blown away. Greg popped up to Brett, his first time at bat. Split off, as we told you, won his 100th career game his last time out. That's a strike, 1-1. Mel, how'd you feel when you won your 100th game?
Gosh, Frank, it's been so long ago, I really can't remember my 100th. I know I didn't feel very good when I lost my 100th game. I do remember that one very well.
That one came back at the plate umpire, Marty Springstead. Well, I know you had a lot of thrills, maybe a few heartbreaks as a pitcher for the New York Yankees. What about the biggest thrill you can recall in your major league career?
Well, Frank, as I look back, you know, I think there's one game that...
In the air to center field, easy chance for Otis. Two down.
One game that'll always stand out, I think, is probably my World Series win in 1964, and that was my first year with the Yankees, and at that time I really expected a lot of those to happen, you know, year after year, but that was the only series that I was in, so that'll always be my biggest thrill in baseball.
Roy White. Roy was a teammate of yours, Mel Stottlemyre, one of the very few left on the Yankee club now. Pops it up. Chance for the catcher. And Darryl Porter puts it away. Three up, three down. We've completed three and a half. It's the Yankees one, the Royals nothing.
Mr. Summers, this gentleman would like to apply for a loan.
I just need a little information.
Right, I have that right here. Now, here's an honorable discharge I got from the Coast Guard. That's me up there in the corner. Now, here's a letter of recommendation I got from my high school gym teacher.
Sir.
Hello.
Sir, we don't need your life story for a loan.
Oh, we make over 2,000 loans a week.
And if you have a checking and savings account with Manufacturers Hanover, we give you up to a 0.5% off your yearly interest rate.
Well, I can save money while I'm borrowing money.
Manufacturers Hanover. It's banking the way you want it to be.
The closer you save for,
the closer you shave for,
the more you will need,
the more you will need.
Great balls of comfort,
great balls of comfort,
to do it with ease.
Great balls of comfort,
oh, just for Noxzema,
Noxzema, great balls of comfort to you.
The closer you shave, the more you need soothing, medicated Noxzema.
Great balls of comfort to you. Move.
Wouldn't you like to be here watching the Yankees in action? Well, your local Midas dealer is giving away tickets to Yankee home games and the exciting Parapro Sweepstakes. Just come into any of the participating Midas muffler shops in the greater New York area and pick up an entry form and the rules. There'll be 500 lucky winners, each getting two tickets to a Yankee home game. And you can enter as often as you want, no purchase necessary. So come to Midas, the muffler and shock pros. Sweepstakes ends on Friday, September 8th.
John Wathan leads off of the Royals. Guidry struck him out in the first inning. Upstairs. Wathan came in batting 295. As Phil told you, had a very important hit, drove in a run last night in the 5-2 KZ win. Well, how about this young man pitching for the Yankees out there, Mel Stottlemyre, Ron Guidry?
Frank, we'd sure like to have him in Seattle. I'm really impressed by him. He's not very big, but he's really got what you call a live arm. You see a lot of foul balls, a lot of pop-ups and things like that. His ball is really doing something at the plate.
Down low, two balls and one strike. Was Guidry, 14 wins, only one loss. Youngster in only his second full major league season as a regular pitcher. In the outer right field, Thurman Munson. I guess that means I got it. And there's one away. What do you think about seeing your old battery mate out there in right field?
I was just going to comment on that. It really looks strange to see number 15 out there in right field. Of course, I'm used to seeing Thurman behind the plate. I understand he's been doing a real good job for you out there.
Had a tough play last night. Even tougher because it led to four Royal runs, one in error. It was a two-base set. Thurman got the ball, couldn't hang on to it. But by and large, he has done very well out there. Amos Otis up high. Otis flied out to Munson, his first trip.
Frank, of what I've seen so far, it looks like maybe a pretty good move. This Heath behind the plate really looks like he has an outstanding arm, and he's thrown two runners out here in the game real easy so far.
He gets started out as a shortstop. And they converted him to a catcher after he signed into pro ball in the Yankee organization. And you've seen two fine examples of his arm in this ball game tonight. Two balls and a strike. He's the kind of kid that wants to play, too. Just wants to make this ball club so bad. Of course, he's made it this year, but he's thinking about next year now. He knows there's a pretty good kid out there in Tacoma. named Jerry Naran. He might have to battle for a catching job.
Yeah, I had an opportunity to see Naran at Tacoma earlier in the year when our San Jose club was there. Looks like a fine youngster.
Three balls and a strike on Otis. Greg Nettles gets the nice hop. And there are two down. Greg's still doing the outstanding job day in and day out down at third base. Whether he hits or not, he's still the best third baseman in the league. And folks here in Kansas City would argue me blue in the face over that. They think they've got the best one.
Well, I'm not really, you might say, impartial, but I think day in and day out, Greg Nettles is as fine a third baseman as you're going to see in either league. And you can't see him one or two games. You have to see him over the course of the season, I think, to really appreciate a player like Greg. He really has done an outstanding job since coming to the Yankees several years ago.
Darryl Porter. Ball on Porter. Bounce back to Guidry his first time up. He's really found a home here, has Porter.
Frank, it's always interesting for me. This is my second trip, I think, in the last couple of years to come into Kansas City to look at the different batting styles that all the hitters have here. Charlie Lau, I guess, is working with all the hitters, but they all seem to have different styles. Hold the bat up high, and Porter, I know, has changed his stance since he came to this ball club.
He's just done an outstanding job for the Royals. Three balls and one strike to him as Guidry is down low with a fastball. The Yankees are leading 1-0 here in the fourth inning, two outs and none on. 3-2 on Porter. I think Darryl, they try to push too much on him, too young. Over in Milwaukee, here's his swing, comes out of that open stance, strides into the ball. Gets a lot of power behind his swing. Not this time. Guidry strikes him out to retire the side. Four strikeouts for Guidry, and at the end of four, it's the Yankees 1, the Royals nothing.
Ladies and gentlemen, you on our Sunday, August 6th, under a summer entertainment schedule, and the Royals...
Oh, doesn't anybody give you your money's worth these days?
You asked for it. Your money's worth and more. The Toyota Corolla two-door sedan, Toyota's lowest priced car. If you can find a better built small car than Toyota, buy it. We bet you can't, because Toyotas are built with the economy and reliability you're asking for. Now's the time to see how much satisfaction you can get for your money.
Finally, I'm getting my money's worth.
More.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
Smaller cars are the toughest on oil. Their hot, high-revving engines can break down an oil's viscosity in no time. In fact, in an independent lab test of SAE 10W40s, Quaker State and Pennzoil both showed significant breakdown in viscosity. Castrol didn't break down at all. Any oil can resist breaking down in the can. Castrol doesn't break down in your engine. Castrol, the motor oil engineered for smaller cars.
Saturday is Old Timers Day at Yankee Stadium, and coming back to celebrate the Yankees' record five straight world championships of a quarter century ago are almost 30 great Yankee stars plus some 25 opponents, including Hall of Famers Bob Feller, new Yankee manager Bob Levin, Lopez, Monty Irvin, Eddie Matthews, Al Rosen, Carl Erskine, Ralph Branca, Bobby Thompson, Junior Gilliam, Tony Oliva, Bobby Avila, to mention just a few. Yankees, DiMaggio, Maddle, Barra, Ford, Rizzuto, Henrik, Keller, Woodling, Mize, Reynolds, Rashi, Pepitone, Bobby Brown, just to name a few more. Old Timers Day this Saturday. Jim Spencer tries to drag the bunt, hits it right back to the pitcher split arm. And no.
The catcher, Mike Heath.
Spencer. Out easily. Sort of a candy play for a pitcher in a mill. That bunt hit right back at you.
Yeah, that's a nice way to start out an inning. You have the guy bunt the ball right back to you.
Here's Heath as a hitter, and he bounces a foul. Today, in addition to his fine arm, Mike Heath had a 13-game hitting streak ended last night. The kind of kid, Mel, that, you see so many youngsters come up, and they want to pull everything, hit the ball a mile. Heath goes with a pitch pretty well. He'll hit the ball to right field.
I was talking to Bill Kane about him earlier, and he said he just tries to put the bat on the ball and has been making good contact and has gotten his share of hits. In fact, he was commenting on the 13-game hitting streak, too.
1-1 count. Two balls and a strike. They talk about batting styles. Let's watch how Heath holds that bat. There it is, way up in the air. And the ball is hit to deep left. And it is in play over the head of Hurdle. Heath may try for third. And Otis's throw will be right into the shortstop. So give Mike Heath his first major league triple. Here it is again. He got a good rip at that one. The ball got up in the air and just kept traveling. Hurdle had him played shallow out there in left field. And the ball is over his head off the wall. You'll see Amos Otis come in from center to pick it up as Heath goes on into third base. Well, the Yankees have a chance to score again here with the runner at third. Only one out. They're going to bring the infield in. Definite advantage for the hitter. And especially on the tartan turf. Foul it back. What are you doing in a case like this, Mel? You got the infield in. You've got to hit the ball right at an infielder to get that play at the plate or even to get an out. You'd rather see that ground ball, rather see the guy pop it up, hit it in the air.
Well, Frank, I think in this ballpark, I think you'd rather see the pop-up in this artificial surface. Like you say, unless the ball is hit right at the infielder, they're not going to get him because it's going to be by him.
And it's hit right at the pitcher. Good play by Splitoff there. His throw pull walking off the bag, but he got back, and Heath has to hold it third. Well, there's something you could do, Mel Stottlemyre. You're a good fielding pitcher. You see Splitoff. Look, Heath back to third base. Then, he didn't pull Wathen off. Wathen got his feet mixed up is what happened, but they got the out. And it's such an advantage to a pitcher to be able to field his position.
Yes, it is, Frank. And that's one thing I've really noticed, I think, in working with young pitchers in our organization anyway. I really try to stress the importance of fielding, but pitchers nowadays just don't seem to think it's a very important part of their game, and you really have a hard time getting them to work on their fielding, but it is so important to be able to stop the ball hit back at you.
And there was an example right there. Splitoff saved himself a run and perhaps a big inning. Rivers fouls it off, and the count is 1-1. I'd have to think as a pitcher, a guy like Rivers, tough man to pitch to. He just slaps at the ball, doesn't try to crank up and hit it out.
Very tough. He's not trying to do anything in particular with the baseball. He's just trying to make contact, punch the ball wherever it's pitched, and is a real tough man at the plate, in this situation especially.
Try to swat that one past the third baseman, Brett. One ball and two strikes.
You know, a batter like Rivers that puts the ball in play and tries to slap the ball around and has the type of speed that he has, he really makes it tough on the infielders. It showed last time he forced Patek into making a throwing error simply because of his speed.
Two balls and two strikes. Rivers has been on twice. He doubled off the pitcher's glove his first time up. Then reached on the air, Mel told you about. Stole a base, came in to score easily. Popped it out into left field, and Hurdle makes the catch on the run to retire the side. The Yankees waste Heath's triple. At the end of 4.5, it's New York 1, Kansas City nothing.
Burgers, that's something we don't do. We broil our burgers on a flame, yeah, broil them just for you. We broil them just for you.
At Burger King, we flame broil our burgers, never fry.
He's got that flame broiled burger that is never fried. Burger King and I.
You had to go and brag about it, Qantas. You couldn't keep it quiet, Qantas. You had to go and tell everybody. Qantas is fastest to Australia. Qantas is fastest from San Francisco to Sydney. Day after day after day. What you need is a little humility, Qantas.
American men are such beasts. I adore them.
but there are times when they can be irritating.
Such roughnecks.
That's when I say, put a little English on your Track 2 razor. These Wilkinson 2 cartridges slip right in, so most twin blade razors can have the famous Wilkinson edge. Be a smooth American. Put a little English on your Track 2 razor.
Al Cowens leads off the fifth for the Royals. Cowens singled in the second, just back off the disabled list. There's an odd batting stance for you. That bat is not laid right on the shoulder. It's sort of laid down behind the shoulder. Whatever makes you comfortable up there. Two balls and no strikes. Collins was hitting 249 before he got hurt. Down toward the left field corner. That's going to be trouble. Played off the wall by Pinella. And Collins has himself a double. Ah, he powered that one. Well, the Royals build a threat here. Their leadoff man is on at second. Here it is again. That pitch inside and gave it a good ride as Pinella, realizing he'll have to play it off the wall, played the carom well. Collins coasting the last few steps. Well, the Yankees 1-0 lead is a bit in jeopardy right now. Clint Hurdle, the batter, grounded out to first baseman Spencer his first trip. Inside. Stottlemyre's happy. I just showed him the Seattle-Toronto final. Seattle won it 4-2.
We need all the help we can get, Frank. Those wins are tough for us to come by.
Ball on a strike. Now, when you pitch for the Yankees, wins were tough to come by sometimes. Do you ever feel that you might have been cheated just a little bit? Not having been there when the Yankees were perennial world champions, pennant winners.
Well, Frank, I don't know. I hate to look back and think that way. I feel like I was fortunate to win the number of games that I did win, and I wouldn't want to change anything if I had it to do all over again. People say, well, perhaps if you had a better club, but maybe if you had a better club, I wouldn't have been there. So.
That's a strike. 1-2 on Hurdle. I think that's a great way to look at it. Foul back. Clear stage of the ball game that Guidry would love to get the strikeout. He shakes Heath off one side and gets another one. Foul ball. All of us wonder just where Guidry gets the power out of that frame, Mel.
He certainly has a live arm. He doesn't have a big body or anything like that, but I would imagine he's got a real live wrist. He certainly gets a lot on the ball.
He got the strikeout. That's four for Guidry. Make that five for Guidry. That is just overpowered. The rookie left-hand hitter Hurdle. Now Heath will go out. They'll talk about Patek. I think day in, day out, with a guy at second base, Patek, as small as he is and everything, is one of the more dangerous hitters in the league.
Yes, he is. He doesn't have a lot of power, but in this case here with a man at second base, a single is going to score the run. So he is a very dangerous man at the plate and always has been a good clutch hitter, Frank.
Guidry struck Patek out back in the second inning. Pardon me. There's one out, a man at second. Down low. The Yankees lead 1-0. Nice play by Heath. He you're a sinker ball pitcher, Mel, you threw the ball down the dirt sometimes. You know how important it is to have a catcher back there that can block those with a guy at base.
It certainly is important, and I was always blessed with a good man behind the plate. The Yankees for years have always had good catchers and seem to keep coming up with that big catcher whenever they need him. It really does help the pitchers, especially in situations like this.
Pop him up. Heath is dancing around and makes the catch in fair territory. That's always a tough play for a catcher right there, too, because the ball is coming back. Starts out as if it's going to be way behind him in foul territory, and then the natural twist of that ball, or that pop-up, carries it back. Watch Heath. Stays right with it.
He stayed right with this ball real good and caught the ball right over his head just like they're supposed to catch, and just a perfect job. I think had it been up just a little bit higher, a little farther out, either the first baseman or third baseman probably should have run him off, but that was the catcher's ball, and he done an excellent job of staying with it.
Notice him catch that ball, look right away to see where the base runner was, Cowan, see if he was trying to do anything. Frank White steps in with two outs. Down the right field line, it's going to be a foul ball, and nobody can reach it. Munson just couldn't quite get there. Collins will cut across back to second. Well, as now an organization man for the Seattle Ball Club, do you folks put any timetable, a certain number of years, as to when your club should be a contender in the American League?
Well, Frank, I think any time they have a new club, especially an expansion club, they always mention 5 years. I don't know whether Seattle will have a contending club in 5 years. They certainly hope so, but I think that's the guideline that they're after is 4 or 5 years.
Frank White pops up. Guidry should get out of the inning as Fred Stanley sets up under it, and Guidry survives the leadoff double at the end of five. It's the Yankees 1 and the Royals nothing.
Here's to good friends. Tonight is kind of special.
Hello, Counselor.
Hi, Dad.
I heard a rumor you finally passed the bar exam.
Yes.
Congratulations. Frank.
Frank will have prime ribs and a couple of Lowenbrau.
Prime ribs? Lowenbrau? What are you doing?
Divine dinner for the guy who put me through law school?
When you want the taste of a truly great beer, tonight, let it be Lowenbrau.
Here's to good friends.
Lowenbrau. Good friends.
Your muffler, Midas size it.
Why put up with a noisy muffler?
Better Midas size.
Midas size it. Midas size your car, and you'll never buy a muffler for it again. Because at Midas, if anything ever goes wrong, we'll replace the muffler free for as long as you own your American-made car. Noisy muffler, don't compromise.
Midas size.
I've driven 500,000 miles in my life, and all of it on Quaker State motor oil. So what oil filter am I using? Are you kidding?
I've used nothing but Quaker State for 22 years. So what oil filter am I using? Are you kidding? Quaker State motor oil has helped my car hit 50,000 miles. So what oil filter am I using?
Are you kidding?
Quaker State helps cars last. So what oil filter should you be using? Are you kidding?
Willie Randolph takes a breaking ball down low from split off. Willie has fly to right, double to right, drove in the only run of the game. Slow curve, two balls and no strikes. Both teams have squandered two scoring opportunities. Yankees had a leadoff double by Rivers in the first inning, couldn't move him. One out triple by Heath in the fifth and couldn't move him. George Brett takes him out. I'll tell you that Brett does a good job defensively at third. George told me earlier this year, though, Mel, we're talking about skills, and I asked him to compare himself with Greg Nettles, and he said that he felt that, obviously, he'd out-hit Nettles for average, probably would score more runs than Nettles. He gave Nettles the edge and power, the home runs, and he said Nettles is the best defensive third baseman.
That's quite a compliment coming from a man like George Brett. I know it maybe it hurt him to say that, but I think he's probably true in all those cases. He is a better average hitter in that case, but Greg certainly has more power.
Thurman Munson hits one down Brett's way, and he throws him out. As Brett will tell you, he said, I'm only 25 years old, and he said, I'm going to be around a while, and he said, I just hope that very soon I'll be the best. And he said, I think I will, but he said, That's one of his ambitions, he said, is to be the fielder that Greg Nettles is.
With an attitude like that, Frank, I'm sure that someday he is going to be able to say that he is going to be the best.
No question about it. Lou Piniella with two outs and nobody on. Lou is grounded out and popped up both times to the third baseman. Brett has had six chances so far in the ballgame. Not this time, it's foul ball. The Yankees are leading 1-0 here in the sixth inning. One ball and one strike. We might mention, just in passing again, that we're playing this ball game with only three umpires tonight. Derwood Merrill has a sore throat. Deep up the gap in left center field, and that one is off the wall. The ball is in play, and a two-base hit for Lou Piniella. Well, Piniella connects his 15th double of the year. It is again. Pitch right out over the plate. Lou gave it a good ride.
I think this ball just misses by just about a foot or a foot and a half at going out of the ballpark. Right.
This is not that easy a ballpark to hit one out. We were talking about it earlier. 385 to the alleys, 410 to center. It's a pretty honest ballpark.
Yes, it is. If they hit one out of this ballpark, they, in most cases, they've usually earned it. I don't think wind is a big factor here neither. So,
Greg Nettles. Split off, jammed in. And I think Porter may have gotten crossed up that time, so they'll get together. There's a lot of controversy, not controversy, a lot of conversation, Mel, about the power hitters. And I'm sure, of course, every hitter varies, but how did you like to do it? You got a power hitter up there in a situation like this, you like to jam him or try to keep the ball away from him?
Well, Frank, if he's a left-handed power hitter, certainly I tried to keep the ball away from him, hoping that he'd pull the sinking fastball and pull me a nice ground ball to second base. And usually I had better luck against this type of hitter in this situation than somebody that hit the ball to all fields.
Nettles fouls it off himself, 1-1. Of course, there, too, we talk a lot about hitters, and we see them up here, and we have an advantage of the replay and the slow motion. See so many hitters day after day go out there and try to pull that pitch away from. And Jim Turner used to say, and Mel, I know he's told it to you, the batter does that, pitcher's got that ring, and the batter's nose just leads him around like that old cow down on the farm.
That's right. Then it's just a case of getting the ball where you want it, and you got him out.
Bouncer to first, foul ball. Well, Nettles can try it again. The Yankees lead 1-0. Chatting with us tonight, Mel Stottlemyre. Fine pitcher for the Yankees. Now the roving minor league pitching coach for the Seattle Mariners. Two outs. Piniella at second base. The Yankees trying to pick up a run here. They're leading 1-0. Two and two on Nettles. Bounce it right back, and Patak will make the play. The Yankees are retired. No runs hit. The man left at a 5.5. It is New York 1 and Kansas City nothing.
Come on, 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 and taste the Pepsi way. Come on, come on, come on, and have a Pepsi day. Your spirits raised up to the sky, you catch the wind, you ride.
Oh, Con Edison, may I help you?
Used to be a customer would call in with a question about a bill or a service, and it could take hours, even days, to find the answer. But now, with Con Edison's new customer service system, I get all the information in seconds, just like this. And it's more up-to-date information than ever before. If you have a question about your bill, use the phone number on your bill to call us. We're here from 8:30 till 5, but our lines are least crowded after 2 p.m. We're working harder to serve you better.
It's no secret that welfare costs are too high and that some people are receiving benefits they don't deserve. But for too long, no one in government really cared. Checks just kept going out and local taxes kept going up. Now Hugh Carey is changing that. He's giving local governments incentives to cut welfare costs. The result? Statewide, the rate of welfare ineligibility has been cut almost in half. That's the kind of help the taxpayers have needed for a long, long time.
George Brett leads off the Royals' sixth. Foul ball out of play. Brett has had two hits in the ball game tonight. 105 hits on the year. Started the game hitting 315. He's now batting 319 overall, and he's a 400 hitter in this ballpark. Leads the league in two base hits with 33. Strike two on him. Hey, Mel. Stottlemyre, good to see you. Take care. Good luck to you.
Thank you, Frank. It's nice visiting with you here in the booth.
Okay, buddy. 0-2 on Brad on a ball. 1-2. Al McCray to follow, and then John Watton. Foul. Back into the upper deck. Souvenir for one of the fans. This ballpark is jam-packed again tonight. Looks like a complete sellout as Bill White comes in to join us. Bill?
Frank, these people average 28,000 a year. Just a little bit below the Yankees. I think the Kansas City at about third average attendance in the league.
Strike three is called. Brett is caught looking, and Guidry has his sixth strikeout.
Yankees average 28,818. The Royals, 28,082. As we look at that slider getting the outside corner on Brett, you don't often strike out, George Brett. That's only the 19th time he has struck out in 330 times at bat. So he keeps the ball in play.
Al McCray, 1-for-2. McCray singled in the first inning, struck out into a double play in the third with Brett breaking on the pitch. McCray struck out, and he threw Brett out to complete the double play. Nettles backs off, and doesn't know where it is. Get off his glove, and he couldn't hang on to it.
You can see that coming, Frank. As soon as he backed up, you knew he was going to get a bad hop. Here it is here. Down low the slider, and a Baltimore chop by McCray. Nettles starts backing up there, and the ball short hopped him. Kick off the heel of the glove, and behind him he couldn't find it. And evidently they give Brett a base hit.
That's the scoring base.
McCray a base hit.
Right, base hit for McCray. Now the Royals have their sixth hit off, Guidry. And John Watton is the batter. Got the plate right at the knees, strike one. Yankees play the infield at double play depth. Outfield is shaded a bit toward right for Watton. Strike two, he snaps it down to first, safe. Well, that was a closer play down at first base than you might think. Almost had McCray off the bag. He's made two fine throws down to second base, and he's got that arm limbered up. Wants to keep it on display. Royals have squandered a couple of scoring opportunities in the ballgame, as we mentioned. So have the Yankees. Yankees lead 1-0. Nettles got the out at second. Safe at first. Nettles gambled a little bit that time, didn't he, Bill? Came in and trapped that ball on a short hop.
Yeah, he wanted to take a short hop. Here it is again. Another bounce to Nettles. This time, instead of going back, Greg came on, got the short hop, went on to second base, and I think Cal McCray playing a little different kind of baseball this year, Frank. Normally, he would have gone after Randolph, but I guess with the umpires earlier in the year calling that double play on the slider running, the guy sliding running into the infielder, I guess McCray's decided to play it safe.
All right, there are two outs. With Wathen at first base and Amos Otis the batter. The Yankees are leading 1-0. Otis has flied to right and bounced out to third. Guidry up high, ball one. Guidry has struck out 6 men in the ball game. He hasn't walked anybody. He has allowed 6 hits. One and one. Otis was trying to take that one downtown. Mike Heath's arm has been a big difference in the ball game. He has thrown out 2 men at second base. Wathen at first. Just outside. 2-1. That's a foul ball. Nettles taking no chances. Fired on to first base anyway, but it's foul. Yankees will be home tomorrow night to play the Cleveland Indians. Jim Beattie will pitch tomorrow night's ball game for the Yankees against Rick Waits of Cleveland. On Thursday afternoon's doubleheader, it'll be at Figueroa and Catfish Hunter for the Yankees. David Clyde and Don Hood will pitch for Cleveland. In the air to right field, Munson should have it. And that will retire the side. Bill White will carry along. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a pleasure. At the end of 6, the score, New York 1, Kansas City nothing.
Hey, I don't want a lot. Just my money's worth.
You asked for it. Your money's worth and more. The Toyota Sport Truck. If you can find a better built truck, buy it. We bet you can't. Not with the car-like ride, comfort, and rugged dependability that comes in this Toyota truck. Now's the time to see how much satisfaction you can get for your money.
At last, I'm going to get my money's worth.
More.
You asked for it, you got Toyota.
Here's two good friends. Tonight is kind of special.
Hey, there he is. Hey, you got here early.
Al, come on, Lone Brown.
Lone Brown.
Well, isn't that what regional sales managers drink?
You? You got it.
When you want the taste of a truly great beer, tonight, let it be Lone Brown.
Congratulations, Big Shot.
Yeah, I suppose you're going to forget your friends now.
Probably.
Let it be Lone Brown.
Funny, but I found the best way to cut down on cigarettes was good smoke.
Take a tip from the people who smoke Tipperillo.
It's the kind of taste that Lotars just couldn't give me.
I went from two and a half packs of regular cigarettes a day to 2, maybe 3 packs of Tipperillos a week. Pretty good, huh?
My husband still enjoys smoking, but now he doesn't smoke as many cigarettes.
Tipperillo, it's a good tip.
Roy White just fouls the first pitch off, leading off of the Yankees here in the 7th inning. Yankees leading 1-0. They have a run on 4 hits. The Royals no runs on 6. Yankee RBI by Willie Randolph. White's 0-2. Good curve by Splittorff. 2 strike. White's line to shortstop, and he's popped to the catcher, Darryl Porter. Roy's 0-2, now batting at 255. Waste pitch, low and in. One ball, two strikes on White. For the Yankees here in the seventh inning, Roy White, Jim Spencer, the first baseman, and then Mike Heath, the catcher, against Paul Splittorff. Got him. Good slider, breaking in and down. One out. Only the second strikeout for Splittorff. If we watch that pitch again, ball go in and down, and Roy White misses it. Here's Spencer. He's bounced to first and tried to drag a bunt past Splittorff, but the pitcher, Paul Splittorff, caught up with it and threw him out. So Spencer's 0 for 2. Ball one. Final. Seattle beat Toronto 4-2. Outside. 2-0. Seattle took a doubleheader from the Blue Jays yesterday. 3-0 on Jim Spencer. The American League, Boston's leading Minnesota 1-0. Bill Lee trying to win his 11th. He's 10-4. He's got a 1-0 lead after 3.5 innings of play in Minnesota. Ball four, Spencer walks on four pitches. Texas 4, Baltimore 3 at the end of 4. Ken Singleton hit his 11th home run in the first inning with a man on for the Orioles. Doug DeCinse is 14th in the 4th with nobody on. Juan Benitez is 6th in the 4th with nobody on for the Rangers. Rangers 4, Baltimore 3 at the end of 4. This is Mike Heath. Pop tech. They get the force at second. That's the only play they have. And they're two outs. Heath broke his bat. The bat almost went as far as the baseball, but Patek stayed with the baseball and forced Spencer at second base as we watch it again. There's the bat going out toward shortstop. Patek backhanding, going to White at second base with a 6-4 force. O'Heath is on at first base. Now two outs, and the batter will be Fred Stanley, the Yankee shortstop. Cleveland leading California 3-1 after 7.5 innings of play. Bernie Carbo and Johnny Grubb home runs in that ball game for the Indians. Carbo is second, Grubb's 11th. We gave you the Seattle-Toronto score. Seattle 4, Toronto 2. Rico Carty and Alan Ashby home runs in that ball game. Carty's 15th, Ashby's 6th. Right at third base with a great play, and welcome back, Stanley going by. George Brett behind the back, backhanding the ball and robbing Stanley of at least a double and the side is retired. No runs, no hits, the man left on base at the end of 6.5. Yankees 1, Royals nothing.
The more fun you have, the more fun you have when you play it back seconds later on your Polavision player.
Good form.
What a form.
When will I ever learn? Good shot.
Polavision, the new instant movies from Polaroid. You could even learn a little bit about yourself.
This amazing motor oil from Exxon can actually save money. Golden Natural Uniflow. Uniflow was tested in cars like yours. After break-in, it delivered an overall average of 16 extra miles per tank full. Savings like that could cut your gasoline bill the equivalent of about 3 cents a gallon. Every day you wait to change to Uniflow could cost you money. Uniflow conserves gasoline, saves money.
Wouldn't you like to be here watching the Yankees in action? Well, your local Midas dealer is giving away tickets to Yankee home games and the exciting ParaPro Sweepstakes. Just come into any of the participating Midas muffler shops in the greater New York area and pick up an entry form and the rules. There will be 500 lucky winners, each getting 2 tickets to a Yankee home game. And you can enter as often as you want. No purchase necessary. So come to Midas, the Muffler and Shock Pros. Sweepstakes ends on Friday, September 8th. I Other American League scores, Detroit leads Oakland 6-1 at the end of six. And it's Chicago 3, Milwaukee 2 after four innings of play. Those are the American League scores. In the National League, Cincinnati and the Mets going at it at Shea. Mets 5, Cincinnati 2 at the end of 6. Pete Rose is 3-for-4 in that ballgame. And he has broken Tommy Holmes' National League record of 37 straight. Rose has now hit in 38 straight ball games, taking dead aim on Joe DiMaggio's 56 straight. Daryl Porter, the catcher, leading off against Ron Guidry in the seventh inning. The Yankees lead this ballgame 1-0. Porter's 0-for-2. He's bounced back to Guidry and struck out. One strike on him. Atlanta beat Philadelphia 4-0. Into center field. Mickey Rivers backpedaling. One out. Montreal and Houston playing at the Astrodome. No score at the end of four. Pittsburgh playing in San Diego later on. The Cubs playing in Los Angeles later on. And the Giants playing host to the Cardinals later on. All those ball games out on the coast. And right here, the Yankees with a 1-0 lead with one out and nobody on in the bottom of the seventh. And you're looking at Al Cowens, a right fielder, who was single to center and doubled to the left. Cowens 2-for-2 against Guidry. Too high, ball one. Yankees a run on four hits. The Royals no runs on six. Nettles at third base. Two outs. Craig Nettles moving quickly to his left, gunning down Cowens. Lynn Hurdle's the batter. He's bounced to first base and struck out. So far, Guidry in the ballgame has struck out six. He has 151 strikeouts now. Still behind the leader in the American League, Nolan Ryan of the California Angels. Strike one on Hurdle. Loop to shallow left. Fred Stanley, sides retired. Stanley with a fine running catch. Three up, three down. At the end of seven, the Yankees lead the Royals 1-0.
Ladies and gentlemen, don't wait until the last minute to make your point.
When you're a lifeguard, you practice all you can, because saving a few seconds may save a few lives. Now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
You know what I want? I want my money's worth.
You asked for it. Your money's worth and more. The Toyota Corolla Liftback. If you can find a better-built small car than Toyota, buy it. We bet you can't. From its design to the quality of workmanship to the way it handles, you can't beat what Toyota gives you. Now's the time to see how much satisfaction you can get for your money.
I am going to get my money's worth.
More.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota. Who's got that same Royal Burger that is never fried? Burger King and I.
Some places fry their burgers, that's something we don't do. We broil our burgers on a flame, yeah, broil them just for you. We broil them just for you.
At Burger King, we flame broil our burgers, never fry.
Who's got that flame broiled burger that is never fried? Burger King.
Mickey Rivers batting for the Yankees in the top of the eighth. The Yankees have a 1-0 lead, and the count on Mickey is a ball and a strike. Rivers scored the Yankee run in the third inning. 1-2. Mickey used his speed. He had a slow bouncer to Freddie Patek at shortstop. Patek charged, had to hurry, threw low. Rivers safe on the air. He stole second base and scored on a double down the right field line by Willie Randolph. Two balls, two strikes on Rivers. The only scoring we've had in this ballgame so far. Otis after the ball. Can he get to it? No. And it's goodbye. And Rivers really shoots in the center. second base. And Starr started to go to third, but changed his mind. That'll be at least a single. I don't know if they'll give Otis an error, allowing Rivers to go on to second base. We'll watch it again. Here it is. Ball's looped into right center field. They were playing Rivers a hit to left. Otis could not short hop the ball. Collins has to pick it up, and Rivers right there changed his mind and settles for second base. And they'll give him a double. No error for Otis. So Rivers leads off with a double, his second double of the ball game. He's down at second base. Nobody out. Here's Willie Randolph. Randolph doubled in the Rivers back in the third inning. He's also flied to right field and bounced to third. Bunnett, good punt by Randolph. Splittorff throws him out, but Randolph gets a sacrifice, a perfect sacrifice. And Mickey Rivers is over at third base with just one away.
The right fielder,
and it'll be up to Munson to try to get him in. Yankees need some insurance runs. Paul Splittorff and Ron Guidry have both been tough here tonight. Splittorff has struck out Munson. He's got him to pop to second. And George Brett threw him out. Royals now will bring their infield in. They want to cut this run down. In the Royal infield, Brett at third, Patek the shortstop, White at second, and Wapa at third. Munson backs off inside, ball one. Thurm now batting at 291, five home runs and 44 runs batted in for the Yankees. Lost a nine-game hitting streak last night, and he's 0 for 3 tonight against Splittorff. Low, 2-0. Getting some action now in the Royal bullpen. Low again, three balls, no strikes on Munson. Well, they might give Munson the green light here. He didn't take a long look at Hauser. Quick glance at him as Rivers is off third base, only one out. Base hit for Munson, and Rivers will score, and the Yankees now lead 2-0. Munson will go into second base with a stand-up double. Well, I don't know, Scooter, if Munson even took a sign from Hauser. He gave him a quick glance and got back in there and just stroked the double on that 3-0 pitch.
Well, here it is again, and he gets it right on the hands. Hit it just right, not too hard, not too soft. Scores Rivers easily, and look at Mick. Hurdle gets it in, but Munson had been missing a lot of pitches last night and his first couple of times up tonight.
Well, there's Thurman off second base now, one away, as the batter is Lou Piniella. The Yankees so far in the ballgame have four doubles and a triple among their six hits. They're going to put Piniella on intentionally. They'd rather pitch to the left-handed hitting Greg Nettles. Ball two. There's Nettles, who's on deck. Yankees now lead 2-0. Two runs, six hits. Royals no runs on six hits against Ron Guidry. Guidry shut out the Minnesota Twins in his last outing. Ball four, and Piniella is intentionally passed, setting up the possibility of a double play and or force. Here's Nettles. Greg is fouled out, flied out, bounced out. Also action on the Yankee bullpen. You see the runners at first and second. Munson down at second, Piniella at first. Strike one on Nettles. Greg on the air, 17 home runs. That's tops on the Yankees, and he's driven in 47 runs. Drove in 100 runs last year for the first time in his big league career. Wapham has go. He'll go to second base and gets the ball past Piniella. They get the force there. So Munson goes to third. Nettles is on at first. There are two outs. And the batter, the DH for the Yankees, Roy White. Roy is lined to short. He's popped to the catcher, Darryl Porter, and he struck out. 0 for 3. The first 10 games played between these two teams, Royals have won 6 and the Yankees 4. They're 3-3 at Yankee Stadium. The Royals have won 3 of the 4 games played here. This is the final game of the series between these two contenders. Ball 1. Unless
they meet in the playoffs.
Yep.
Could happen.
There's Mutson off third. Nettles was off first. It's a ball and a strike on White. Well, normally, when you change managers, one or two things happen. You go off on a long winning streak. That'll be a base hit. Mutson score easily, and the Yankees now lead 3-0. Well, you continue to play the way you've been playing.
Yeah, that's true.
Or worse. Don't start with Kenny Boyer over the Cardinals. He got him just in time when they started losing.
That's just like Larry Doby over with the White Sox.
Yep.
It's tough to join a club in the middle of the year. You're going to be a manager. Start with spring training.
So Roy White has just driven in his 26th run. The Yankees lead 3-0, and you're looking at Jim Spencer, the first baseman. He's bounced to first, bunted and was thrown out, and he's walked. He's 0 for 2. Yankee runners first and third, two outs in the top of the eighth. Good grip by Spencer. Got around quickly on it, ball up and in. One strike. This crowd seemed down to you?
Oh, very much so. It was just one inning where they started to make a little bit of noise.
I guess Ron Guidry shuts everybody up.
Yeah.
He goes out there with that fastball.
And... yep.
That's a base hit. Nettles will score. The Yankees now lead 4-0. Jim Spencer, who doesn't normally get the hit against left-handers, rips a single to left field, driving in his 21st run of the year, and the Yankees now lead 4-0. Here it is again.
Right out of way, and he went with him. Very seldom does he go that way to left field. Clint Hurdle grabs it, but it looks like that's going to be all for a split-off. Well, it's a big run. The Yankees now lead 4-0, and it's the mad Hungarian, Al Rabowski. And he'll shake the crowd up. The hand is for split off, leaving. And we'll be back right after this.
Come on.
Come on, come on. It's a Pepsi invitation.
Noisy muffler? Don't compromise.
Hey, your muffler, Midas size it.
At Midas, the muffler specialists.
Well, there he is, Grabowski. He's won 4, lost 3 so far this year. Good earned run average, 2.64. And by far the most saves of any Kansas City relief pitcher, 13. And he'll go into his act. This is part of it. Kicks the dirt away from the rubber. But just before he throws that first pitch, that counts to the hitter. He'll go into his act.
Remember Pete Vukovich?
Yes.
Pitched with the Toronto Blue Jays last year. Well, the Cardinals have him now, and he's picked up an act.
Oh, no kidding?
Yep. Along with 7 wins.
Yeah, he's doing a pretty good job.
Doing an excellent job. They had used him in the bullpen at St. Louis for a while, and they've started starting him, and he's done well. But
what's his act?
He yells at the batters.
No kidding?
Yep, talks to the baseball, talks to himself. He says that his idol is Rasputin.
Oh, man. Rasputin was mean. How do you like that? Well, I tell you, these ball players are getting smarter and smarter. They know if you got a knack to go along with having a good year. Not only brings people in, gets them excited, but it gets you more money.
Entertainment.
Yep.
Well, Roboski finishes, and this is the act that Phil is talking about. Just getting ready to happen.
We get a good look at it from the center field camera now. Usually you get it when his back is turned. He rubs the ball, and he meditates. And then when he gets finished, he pounds the ball in the glove. And then the crowd is swelling up now, and here he goes. Yeah.
So Harbosky will have to face Mike Heath of the Yankees with two outs. Yankee runners at first and second. The Yankees already lead 4-0 in the eighth inning. Strike one on Heath. Paul Splittorff went 7 2/3 innings, gave up four runs, all four runs on eight base hits. He walked 2-1 intentionally, and he struck out two. Mike Heath has triple, popped up, and forced a runner. Two strikes on Heath. There's White off second base. Boy's really been bouncing around down there at second base. Jim Spencer's at first. Yankees have scored three times here in the eighth inning to get a little bit of insurance against the Royals. They had a 1-0 lead coming into the eighth inning. One ball, two strikes on Heath.
Speaking of 2-2, the Twins came up with two runs in the bottom of the fifth. They lead the Red Sox 3-1 now at the end of 5.5.
Red Sox having some injury problems. Rick Burleson, Jim Rice. Still two balls, two strikes on Heath. Roboski going solely with the fastball to the young catcher. He's keeping it up.
Red Sox were lucky to come up with that Andy Hassler, and their bullpen's going to be hurt. And they started Bergmeier in one game and then had to bring in Campbell in the first inning when Torres was thrown out last night.
Mike yelling at umpires again?
Yep, he bumped him on a balk call.
3-2 on E. Ball up and in. He simply gets down and gets out of the way, and the count is now 3-2. And once again, Roboski will go through his act. Pitch inside. He's on at first base. Spencer is down at second. White's on at third. And the batter for the Yankees is Fred Stanley, the shortstop. Stanley's 0-3. Bounced to third twice. Last time, a great play by Brett throwing him out. Brett backhanded the ball. Looked like the ball might have been by him. And threw Stanley out at first base. batting a 225 with a home run, 7 runs batted in. Ball one. So if you throw Sammy high, he'll duck under a lot of those pitches. You see the base is loaded with the Yankees. Straight back and out of play. Ball and a strike. 2 outs. Yankees leading 4-0 in the top of the 8th inning here at Royal Stadium. The shortstop makes the play easily on that little looper, and the side is retired. Yankees send Tinman up, 3 up and score. And at the end of 7.5, the Yankees lead Kansas City 4-0.
The Quintrix two-color picture tube from Panasonic brings you a very lifelike picture. Because Quintrix 2 is our inline picture tube, with an extra pre-focus lens that concentrates and focuses the electron beam to bring you Panasonic's sharpest picture ever. So lifelike, you may even feel you're part of the picture. Quintrix 2, one more reason Panasonic is just slightly ahead of our time.
We both love all the Colonial Bacons. The only question is, Jim, which one is the best?
Let's see, Billy.
The special cut bacon? Cut from where the bacon's best. Colonial's maple sugar cured bacon with a Vermont country flavor. The lean taste of Colonial beef strips, a tasty beef blend.
You know, that's good, too.
Or Colonial smoky strips, a delicious combination of pork and bacon. Well, Jim, what's your favorite?
So far, the first 4.
Next time you cook, and I'll choose.
Colonial Bacons. Mm. Which one is best?
When you farm your own land, the work never ends. But you do it with pride and all the strength you can muster. But now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
Just 6 base hits and he has struck out 6. Strike one on White. Strike 2 on White. Nothing but fastballs. Guidry just ran back now, throwing it in there. 0-2. Too high with the fastball. 1-2. Yankees 4 runs, 8 hits. The Royals no runs on 6. Got him with a good slider going down and in. Guidry now 7 strikeouts. And they're 2 outs.
Right, here's that last pitch. Starts out as a strike, ends up a ball, but White couldn't check the swing.
Well, it's amazing what he's done the last couple of years. Clear after almost quitting baseball.
Yep.
Coming up with that good hard slider to go along with the good fastball. This is George Brett. Willie Randolph will throw him out. And the side is retired, 3 up and 3 down. At the end of 8, the Yankees lead Kansas City 4-0.
Oh, doesn't anybody give you your money's worth these days?
You asked for it. Your money's worth and more. The Toyota Corolla two-door sedan, Toyota's lowest priced car. If you can find a better built small car than Toyota, buy it. We bet you can't, because Toyotas are built with the economy and reliability you're asking for. Now's the time to see how much satisfaction you can get for your money.
Finally, I'm getting my money's worth.
More.
You asked for it. You got it, Toyota.
How do I get a checking account that won't cost me anything?
At Manufacturers Hanover, just keep $400 in a savings or checking account, and your checking is free.
Well, you see, now I'm going to be writing a lot of checks. I got, look here, I got Plan of the Month Club, Cheese of the Month Club, and then I got Shirley Psychiatry Bills, and that's my canary. She's afraid of height.
Oh.
You have your own problems. All right, just fine, thank you. What I'm trying to say is, what would happen if I accidentally bounce a check?
You can apply for overdraft protection.
Really? Where do I sign?
Manufacturer's Hanover. It's banking the way you want it to be.
Got a new pitcher for the Royals as we watch the view from the fountains out in center field. The new pitcher, Steve Mingori, another left-hander. He relieves Al Roboski, who pitched to two men in the eighth inning, walked one and got one on a looping to looping pop-up. So Roboski went one-third of an inning, gave up no runs, no hits, walked one, didn't strike out anybody. Steve Mingori is making his 26th appearance, his 26th relief appearance for the Kansas City Royals. He's picked up four saves, one win, two losses. Pretty good ERA, 2.06. So Mickey Rivers, who's had a good night, he's doubled twice. Scored twice, stolen a base. Will lead off against Steve Mingori. Mickey now batting at 260. Five home runs, 26 runs batted in. Ball one. Now with 13 doubles on the year. Hudson leads the Yankees in doubles. He has 16. Chambliss 15. Pinella 14. One ball, one strike on Rivers. One and two. Back up the middle and smothered by Mingori. Mr. Hurry gets his bag. Mingori, the pitcher, simply smothered that ball. Let's watch it again. Right back up the middle. Bang, right there. Keeps control. Hurries the ball to first base, one away. Willie Randolph. Slide out. Doubled in a run. Bounced to third. Sacrificed. He's been productive tonight. Two for three. Curveball is a strike. Two strikes on Randolph. Finals, Cleveland beat California 5-1. Seattle beat Toronto 4-2. Detroit 11, Oakland 2. All those finals in the American League. Got him with a breaking ball. Two outs. I'll bring on Paul Blair batting for the first time. Blair went out to play right field, replacing Thurm Munson. Manager Bob Lemon going for the defense in the late innings. So Blair up for the first time. Ball's batting 186. He's only been up 86 times, 16 base hits. Strike one. Five doubles, no triples, two home runs, 10 runs batted in. Two strikes. The Royals will send in Hal McRae, John Wathen, and Amos Otis in the bottom of this inning, the bottom of the ninth. They're down 4-0. And so far, Guidry has limited the Royals to just six base hits, and he has struck out seven. Ron Guidry, once again, has been tough, looking for his 15th win of the year. He's lost just one. One and two. Two balls, two strikes. Here you say something about somebody kicking doors down.
Greg Corbett.
That's foul.
When they had lost and dropped 7.5 games behind, Billy Martin was talking to the press and had the door locked, and Corbett broke the door down.
Billy Hunter.
What did I say? Freudian slip? Oh, okay. Yeah, it was Billy Hunter. And he kicked the door down. He said, how can we be this far behind? All the money I spend, I'm going to go broke.
Well, Brad's from New York, isn't he?
Yes. Everything's heating up.
Two balls, two strikes on Blair. 3-2. In the air, left center. Clint Hurdle moving to his left. The left fielder calling. And the side is retired. 3 up and 3 down. Bottom of the ninth coming up. The Yankees 4, the Royals nothing.
You work the docks. The ship's too big, the loads are too heavy, and the days are too long. But every day you do it, and another ship with a full belly heads out for sea. And you head in for Miller time. Time to relax with the best tasting beer you can find. Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
Which hitters will lead the Yankees in batting average, home runs, and RBIs this season? If you think you know, why not enter the Miller High Life Yankee Hitter Sweepstakes? There will be more than 100 winners, and first prize includes a Panasonic video cassette recorder, a 19-inch color TV, and a pair of box seat tickets to all Yankee home games next season. Official rules and entry blanks are available at participating Miller High Life retailers, or send a self-addressed stamped envelope to be received by August 15th. To Miller High Life Yankee Sweepstakes, Post Office Box 8000, Blair, Nebraska, 68009. All right, bottom of the ninth inning. Ron Guidry working on a shutout. Got some tough men to face, McRae, Watham, and Otisville.
All right, Scooter, how McRae, 2 for 3. He has 2 of the 6 hits given up by Ron Guidry. Both singles, and he's also struck out. Yankees leading 4-0, ninth inning. Strike one on McRae. Hal backs off the plate, has to dive it on that fastball away from him. Strike two.
All right, and the Twins have come up with another run. They lead the Red Sox 4-1, and Wright is in pitching for the Red Sox now in the sixth.
1 ball, 2 strikes on McRae. Leading off for the Royals, ninth inning. Still a ball and 2 strikes. Foul outside third, still a ball and 2 strikes on McRae. Got him! Good slider coming down and in. Guidry now struck out 8, and there's one away.
Here's that last pitch again. Beautiful breaking pitch. Looks like Guidry's return to his strong form, Bill, of finishing up strong.
Well, you know, I don't think he threw as hard as he normally does earlier. He tried to pace himself a little bit better. Then he came on and he's really started humping the ball up. Frank White struck him up. Got some good fastballs and got him with a slider. This is John Wathan. That struck out, fly to right field and forced a runner. He's 0 for 3. Out of play, a ball and a strike. Blair in right field. Two outs. Oh, Ron Guidry went on away from his 15th win of the year. And his fourth shutout. That'll get his ERA down around two. As it came into the ballgame with an ERA of 2.11. Amos Otis is 0 for 3. Most of the Royal batters stand off the plate like that, Scooter, and with that fastball on the outside part of the plate, they just can't get to
it. I know it.
Well, it should be out of play. No chance of Blair. That'll be about two rows in down the right side. Two strikes on Amos Otis. That's out of play down the right side. Still no balls and two strikes on Amos Otis. Ron Guidry so far has been in complete control of the Kansas City Royals. Got in trouble in the first inning, giving up singles, but he struck out Wotham, got Otis and Porter. About the most serious problem he had. Out of play. Gave up a leadoff double to Al Cowens in the fifth inning, but then struck out Hurdle. Got Patek on a pop-up and also Frank White. Other than that, he's had fairly good clear sailing. Two strikes on Otis. Greg Nettles at third base. This should do it. And it's all over. Final put out 5-3. And the final score, Yankees 4, Royals nothing.
And you were absolutely right, Bill White. Ron Guidry's earned run average now 1.99. Imagine that, they're only batting .212 against Guidry.
That's the American League total batting against Guidry's at .212. That's not too bad. American League batters are hitting just .212 against Guidry.
Yes.
I would think overall they're probably hitting around .250 average-wise, so that's pretty good average.
All right, here are the totals in the ballgame for the Yankees. 4 runs, 8 hits, no errors. For the Royals, no runs, 6 hits, 1 error. Guidry the winner, his record now 15-1. Split off the loser is 11-9. And it was a shutout for Guidry, as Bill told you, and the Yankees picked up 1 run in the third inning. It was an unearned run as Rivers reached on an error, stole second, scored on Randolph's double, then scored 3 more in the eighth inning to ice it. So that's it. From Royal Stadium, this is Phil Rizzuto for Bill White, Frank Messer, and Don Carney saying so long from Kansas City. Once again, the final score, the Yankees 4, the Royals nothing. Thanks for tuning in. Our next Yankee telecast will be Friday night, July 29th at 8 p.m. from Yankee Stadium, the Yankees and the Minnesota Twins. Participating advertisers were the Miller Brewing Company, brewers of Miller High Life. If you've got the time, we've got the beer. Toyota, it's great to be a Yankee and it's great to be the official car of the Yankees. Toyota, you asked for it, you got it. Manufacturers Hanover, where it's banking the way you want it to be. Burger King, where you get the best Don Burgers, always flame broiled juicy. And the New York Yankees.
This is Harry beside his car. Harry's also beside himself because the top of his car looks like the bottom. But watch this. You said it, Harry. Son of a Gun. It's new from STP. Son of a Gun helps restore and protect vinyl, rubber, and leather. It makes old vinyl tops look younger. And dashboards, door panels, weather stripping, bumper guards. Son of a Gun helps restore and protect vinyl, rubber, and leather. New from STP.
Son of a Gun.
Hi, I'm Lou Piniella. Whenever I have a minute, I like to find out what's happening in other sports, so I call Sports Phone. 999-1313. That's 999-1313. It's fast and it's first with news about all sports. Hey, they won! Gotta go now.
If you can't get to the game, get to the phone. Sports phone. 999-1313.
Tony Curtis takes charge of the team that became America's national disaster.
What have you got against daycare?
You like daycare?
Oh, I love daycare.
Then you go to daycare.
And once you see them in action, you'll know why. When the Bad News Bears go to Japan.
You're gonna get in here, sucker!
Rated PG.
Now playing at a theater near you.
The New York Apples, led by Vetus Gerolaitis, take on the Boston Lobsters with expert color commentary by Billie Jean King, Monday night at 8 on 11 Alive.
Tuesday, July 25, a near miracle as the first baby conceived in a test tube is finally born. We'll have that story and the nearly miraculous survival of plane crash victims.
A Queens mother and her three sons are arrested as a robbery quartet and are returned to a Lower East Side synagogue struggling for survival.
In action sports, Pete Rose sets the record and Bob Lemon starts his with the Yankees. Taped highlights of both. The record was 37 straight games with at least one base hit. 33 years ago by Tommy Holmes. Pete Rose put that away tonight with a base hit in the third inning. Here he is against Greg Swan. It's his second trip to the plate. A low fastball, just like last night. Clean single to left field. That makes it 38 straight. The crowd of more than 40,000 went wild. And the irony, of course, is that the guy's record he broke, Tommy Holmes, works for the Mets, was at the stadium, and came out to personally congratulate Rose. And what a record it is. When you consider that he is 37 years old, they usually say that the athlete reaches his peak at the age of 28, 29, or 30, and he is still going strong. Now he sets his sights on Joe D's 56 straight. Meanwhile, the Yankees got off to a flying start under their new manager, Bob Lemon. We'll have highlights of that and all the scores later in Action News. Pat?
Thank you, Jerry. New York City is halfway.
You got Mom to help.
No.
Nope.
Soldiers.
President Carter's popularity is for several months, and his wife thinks the press is partly to blame. Rosalind Carter say that reporters often focus on the negative and irrelevant, failing to point up her husband's accomplishments. Gerald Rafshoon handled the Carter media image during the presidential campaign and is now in the White House calling the shots. Last night, he ordered presidential advisor Mitch Costanza to cancel an interview set for today on ABC's Good Morning America. The reason? She hadn't cleared it with him. More from Mark Walton.
As the story goes, Midge Costanza was told on short notice to cancel her appearance on ABC, although she'd made the commitment some 6 weeks ago. The call came last night from the president's new communications advisor, Jerry Rafshoon, informing Costanza that he'd issued a directive for all White House senior staff members to coordinate their appearances through his office. Midge said she agreed with the idea, but that she'd not been aware of the rule, and so she refused to personally call ABC at that already late hour. Rafshoon canceled the appearance for her, assigning domestic affairs advisor Stuart Eisenstadt to fill in, on grounds that it was more important to have a thorough discussion of domestic policies than to have Midge Costanza on the show. Costanza's reaction, she'll never let anyone decide when or where she goes. Rafshoon has been unavailable for comment. At the White House, this is Mark Walton.
You know, Jerry, there have been so many managers hired and fired in baseball that there must be some statistics on whether
yeah,
what
they always
the first
seem
game
to win, and Bob Lemon won his first tonight. And the first thing I thought of was Eddie Stanky, if you recall, his last managerial job of the majors. He won a game, then he quit the next morning, 1-0. So we got Lemon's home number. We're going to check overnight just to make sure. Duke of Wellington beat Napoleon and quit. He's 1-0. Same thing. Now, tonight, the Yankees win it 4-0, and the big guy was Ron Guidry. Unbelievable. Great control, good fastball, that sneaky slider. He won his 15th game, his second consecutive shutout. His earned run average is under 2. Here's the only run he really needed. In the third inning, Rivers to Patek rushes the throw because of the speed. Error, and it cost him. Rivers steals second. Randolph jumps on a curveball, hits it into the right field corner. The Yankees lead 1-0, and it stayed that way with Splitsoff going for KC until the eighth inning. Again, it was Rivers who started the rally for the insurance runs. Bloops one to right center. Otis can't make it, gets past him. Rivers goes to second. He was sacrificed to third by Randolph, and then Munson came up and hit an inside pitch down the left field line to make it 2-0. Yankees got two more. They win it 4-0. Jackson did not play, neither did Chambliss. Bob Lemon is 1-0. Yankees may be rolling again. We'll see. In Minnesota, meanwhile, important score. Twins lead the Red Sox after 6.5. If Boston loses, the Yankees will trail by 9.5. Chicago over Milwaukee in the eighth. Baltimore 7-6 over Texas in the seventh. Detroit beat Oakland big. Cleveland over California, a final. Seattle beat Toronto. You thought Pete Rose was going to choke because of the pressure. The guy gets hits in his sleep. Forget it. Nothing bothers him. And tonight he did it. 38 consecutive games, a new National League record. The Mets won, but Pete Rose was the big story. Here is that hit. Second time at the plate. 38 in a row. Clean single to left. You know what? He says, all right, it's tough to catch DiMaggio's 56, but I think I can do it. Sparky Anderson says, I don't think anybody can do it, but I don't doubt Pete Rose anymore. Meanwhile, the Mets won the game 9-2, a big hit here in the fourth inning by Lenny Randle with the bases loaded. A rare error by Griffey, and another one coming up by Joe Morgan, who throws the ball past first. The Mets got five in that inning, and that's all Craig Swan needed. He won it 9-2. In Philadelphia tonight, Tommy Boggs shut out the Phillies 4-0 for the Braves. Chicago, L.A., St. Louis, San Francisco just getting underway. Also on the coast, Pittsburgh leads San Diego after 2.5 in the eighth. Montreal over Houston, 1-0. Now let's check the races. Nothing at Belmont, but action at Roosevelt tonight. The Daily Double